I am Muhammad Zamzam. Through my YouTube channel, I'll be uploading a series of videos in the Mendelian genetics. In 1863, Gregor Mendel conducted some experiments on guardian P, through which he revealed two secrets or laws of inheritance. In this video, I'm illustrating Mendel's first law. Mendel's first law states that during gametes formation, the alleles for a given gene segregate or separate from each other. Therefore, each gamete carries only one allele for a given gene. Before going ahead and explaining how Mendel was able to come up with this conclusion, I'd like to spot the light on the factors that led to the success of Mendel experiments. First of all, it's very important to mention that Mendel came up with this conclusion before even people know what DNA is, what chromosomes are, or what meiosis is. One of the most important factors was documentation of results. Mendel was good at mathematics. He counted very well. He was able to determine the ratios between the individuals. He also was a keen observer. He observed very well. And he was able to distinguish between the phenotypes. But most importantly, that he was precisely and accurately documenting what he observed. One other factor that led to success of Mendel experiment was the choice of the experimental plant. In his experiment, Mendel employed guardian bee, and guardian bee actually produced larger flowers, which make it easy to emasculate them for crosses. They have larger number of progeny, and this makes it suitable for statistical analysis, and it has contrasting traits. You find guardian bee that is tall, you find guardian bee that is short, you find guardian bee that has round seeds and other that has wrinkled seeds. So you can easily distinguish between the contrasting traits. Mendel also realized that in order to compare one variable at a time, it's very important to generate true breeding lines. True breeding lines are lines that when their progeny are cultivated, they produce individuals that look exactly like their parents. So, for example, if I have a true breeding line that is short in all the successive generations, I will get shorter plants. If I have a true breeding line that produces wrinkled seeds, in all the successive generations, all the individuals will produce wrinkled seeds. So, basically, here is what Mendel did. Mendel crossed a true breeding line that is tall to a true breeding line that is short, and he found that all the offsprings in the F1 were tall. In the F2, Mendel found that there are two different phenotypes. He found that the majority of the plants were tall, however, the minority were short. And mathematically, he found that the ratio between the tall plants to the shorter plants is almost 3-to-1. Mendel almost obtained the same results with the other traits that he investigated, with the shape of the seed, with the color of the seed, and with the color of the flower. So at this stage, Mendel hypothesized that there are factors that control the appearance of the traits, and he called these factors alleles. He hypothesized that one of these alleles are dominant, one of these alleles is dominant over the others, and that's why we have only one phenotype in the F1, and these alleles segregate or separate from each other during the formation of gametes, so each gamete carries only one allele. To confirm that, Mendel conducted another type of crosses. He crossed the F1 to one of the parents, which is short. This type of crosses, we call it test cross or back cross. When you cross the F1 to one of the parents, this is called back cross. So Mendel did that to confirm his hypothesis, and he obtained a result of a ratio 1-to-1, one tall plants to one shorter plants. And according to his hypothesis, this is true because according to what he hypothesized, that the F1 carries both alleles, so it will give two types of gametes, And the true breeding line, one of the parents, will give only one type of gametes. So this explained the hypothesis that during gametes formation, the alleles for a given gene segregate or separate from each other, therefore each gamete carries only one allele. That's basically all for Mendel's first law. Before going ahead to my next video, I'd like to share with you some concepts or some terms in Mendelian genetics. First of all, here we have the definition of allele. Allele is one of two or more forms a gene may take. We have homozygous, which is a state in which two alleles or all the alleles for a given gene are the same. And we have heterozygous, which is a condition in which all the alleles or one allele is different from the other alleles for the given gene. We have dominant or dominance. In case of dominance, you will find that one allele is expressing itself at the expense of the other alleles, and this allele will be called dominant. But the case itself is named dominance. We have genotype. Genotype is the specific allelic combination for a certain gene or for a set of genes. And finally, we have phenotype, which is the physical appearance of an individual or of a trait. In this slide, I will explain the previous terms. Here I have three different genotypes, and they produce only two phenotypes. So as I described, or as I defined, the genotype is the allelic combination. So here I have identical allelic combination. I have identical alleles here, and I have different alleles here. They produce only two phenotypes. As I defined, phenotype is a physical appearance. So here I have tall plants, and here I have shorter plants. Also, I described the term of heterozygous and homozygous. So here I have homozygous. So the plants are homozygous for the trait of the height. The plants are also homozygous for the trait of the height. And here I have heterozygous because I have two different alleles. So the plants are heterozygous for the trait of the height. We described the term dominance or dominant. Here, this plant or this allele, which is for the height of the plant that give tall phenotype, is dominant over the other allele that give short phenotype. And that's why I have tall plants, because one allele, which is for the phenotype that gives the tall plants, is dominant over the other. It hides its effect. So that's basically all. At the end, I'd like to thank you for watching my videos.